Welcome to all. My name is Purnima Sethupathi. I'm going to present a medieval Indian history. The theme is the Mughal art and architecture. So the Mughal art and architecture create a tremendous change in the history of India. So we start with the introduction. So the medieval period saw the great developments in the field of architecture. With the coming of Muslims to India, many features came to be introduced in buildings. The development of Muslim style of architecture of this period can be called Indo-Islamic architecture or Indian architecture influenced by Islamic art. The earliest building of this period is Qutb-ul-Mosque or Qutb Minar in Delhi. So let me start with the features of the Mughal school of art. So this school has specific style of South Asian paintings. It was confined to miniatures either as a book depictions or individual work to be kept in albums. This practice materialized from Persian miniature paintings with Indian influence of Hindus, Buddhists and Jains. So it mentioned the miniature painting is previously, the ancient history and all the Buddhists and Jains, they followed the mural and fresco paintings. It's seen in the cave of the rock and seen in the temple and some of the pillars they have painted in the theme of Ramayana and Mahabharata and Buddhist Jataka stories and the life and death of Buddhas. So all these things it's came under in the wall paintings and all. Say they use the natural essence from fruits and vegetables. After this Mughal school of art, they used a different type of materialized, especially the Persian miniature painting, it related with the albums. So that's created a new style of paintings that was created in India. So next is a large tombs and surrounded by four smaller tombs. So the large tombs is the best example is Taj Mahal. It's have a large room and surrounded by the smaller rooms. So next one is the use of white marble and red sandstones. So the white marble is used in Taj Mahal and red sandstone used in the best examples is Red Fort. So use of delicate ornamentation works, a lot of floral designs and some of the animals including in this ornamental designs. For example, they including pachinkari and decorative work and jali laced screens. It's like diamond shaped laced screens and all they using in the pillars and plasters and all. So the monumental building surrounded by gardens on four sides is the best example is Fatehpur Sikri. Akbar introduced this type of gardens and Shah Jahan is also using. Taj Mahal is the best example. Humayun Tomb is the best example for this garden on four wall sides. And they used Persian and Arabic calligraphic inscriptions. For example, in ancient history and all, some of the expeditions done by the ruler, they inscripted in Tamil Brahmi scripts or some other the type of scripts in epigraphical writings used in these walls and all. In Mughal architecture and arts, they using this Persian and Arabic calligraphy inscriptions. Inscribed from the Qurans and all. So next slide shows this example of the domes, four domes and all. And this is the best example is domes as well as the gardens surrounded by the four walls. And this is a floral miniature floral previous slides I mentioned. Then it's a continue of the Mughal school of art. It's seeing the court scenes, portraits, hunting scenes, lovers and battles, etc. And added new colors like peacock blue and red Indian. So already I have mentioned that our ancient history and all, they used some of the vegetables and paintings essence. They introduced new peacock blue and red colors used in this paintings and all, miniature, especially the miniature paintings. So Jaswant and Dashwant were the two famous painters of Akbar's court. The Mughal painting reached its zenith during Jahangir's rule. So Jahangir was a great pattern of painting have created. These two painters were being followed by Akbar and later it followed by Jahangir. So it reached his peak. So next slide shows I mentioned the peacock blue and red colors, and this is a theme, the court discussion, and all they used miniature paintings. So next we start with the art and architecture from Babur to Aurangzeb. So the Babur is first Mughal emperor to start this Mughal dynasty in India. So and ended with the Aurangzeb. So this was a specific period that art and architecture was flourished during this period. So Babur built the Kabul Mark Mosque at Panipat. So Panipat is the best example for the first war of Panipat. Is a foundation of Mughal dynasty in India. So he built mosque in there, and Sambal it's Rogilkan. Again one another mosque is there. Humayun city at Donpana, and Jomali mosque and mosque of Isha Khan at Delhi. And Haji Begum, the wife of Humayun, she built the remembrance of his husband Humayun tomb, and Akbar Agra fort and Jahangir Mahal in Agra based on the designs of Man Mandi, and Lahore Palace, Allahabad Fort and Temple of Babur. And next is several buildings related with Fatehpur Sikri that include Panch Mahal. Panch Mahal Mosque is very best example. They have well planned the plant on the Buddhist Viharas and all. So this slide shows the Humayun tomb. The Haji Begum built the remembrance of his husband Humayun, and this is the best examples of red sandstone, and this is best examples of white marble, and its contemporary says symbol of love. So all these are best examples of architecture of Mughal Empire. So next it's a continuity is a Lahore Palace and Allahabad Fort and Temple of Govind and Devat Vardhana, and several buildings of Fatehpur Sikri that include Panch Mahal plan on Buddhist Vihara, Diwan I Khas and Jodhapur Palace. It built during Akbar's period because Akbar married this Jodhabai. Also he built this Jodhapur Palace, and Jahangir, already I have said, is a very patron and zenith in his during his reign. So Indo-Persian style he is followed, and Modi Masjid at Lahore, own tomb at Shahdar, and Nur Jagan Idu Dhmal Das marble tomb at Agra. In Pidra technique, Dura is a double technique that used this marble tomb at Agra, and Sajigan at Agra Taj Mahal, and Modi Ki Mosque and Kansa Mahal and Shesha Mahal and Jasmine Palaces. So we have to conclude, the Mughal architecture is a type of Indo-Islamic architecture developed by the Mughals in the 16th, 17th and 18th century. Throughout the ever-changing extent of the empire in the Indian subcontinent, it incorporates the Indian elements with the Persia and Islamic style. So it creates a zenith, and also it creates tremendous changes in the Indian medieval history period. Till now we talked about the marvelous and fabulous work done by the rulers, built the Taj Mahal, Red Fort and Humayun Tomb, and Panch Mahal, Pearl Mosque. All this mask, and they were created new techniques, and also they used different colors and floral colors, and laced screens, ornamented shell works and pillars and pilasters, marbles, and especially they used the pittorino techniques. Some of this are very interesting to learn more about this Mughal art and architecture. Thank you for watching this video.